Hey guys, it's Bubbly. Welcome back to the channel and to another speed build. And today we are doing another community lot. I have been on a community lot kick lately and I wanted to focus on using the roller rink that came with the season's pack. So I decided to build a structure or a community lot that was focused on a roller rink, and I wanted it to sit below the level of the rest of the build. So I created a basement and then removed the roof and then slipped the roller rink right in there. So it sits below everything else that's on this lot. And then I was trying to decide, well, what else do I want to have to go along with this? Because I didn't want it to just be a roller rink. I wanted it to have some other things going on. So this lot was a fun activity place for Sims to go. So I decided to create like a strip mall, very small strip mall, more like an open air type feel mall, not necessarily like your traditional strip mall. I really love how it turned out. The main building of the mall area has a restaurant and then four shops attached to it, and all of the shops have their own separate entrances. You cannot access them from within the building. So the main restaurant part is the very center of the building, and I wanted it to be like an open air feel, so there aren't any walls around it. I just put some fencing and some half walls and some archways in there to kind of section off the kitchen area from the dining area. And that's basically it. To the left of the main building, I created a small structure to represent the station where you would rent your roller skates. So it's not a functional, or it's not necessary for your Sims to actually do that. I did place a bar in there so it can be used in that capacity. So there will be a Sim that populates there that your Sim can order drinks from. And then you can just use your imagination and pretend that they're actually renting the roller skates. So I used a couple of those cabinets that came with the Laundry Day Stuff Pack. They're one of my favorites. And then I stacked in some of the shoe racks in there to represent the roller skates. And then I also used some of the baskets that came. Actually, I think they're part of the debug objects. So I will leave instructions on that down below if you're not sure what that is. So I put some of those baskets, and then I put the rolled towels in those baskets, and that was to represent socks. So, because you gotta have socks when you go roller skating. I know for me personally, they're not necessarily when I went roller skating, but when I went bowling, I completely forgot that you need to wear socks when you rent those shoes. You don't want to be putting your bare tootsies in community shoes, which sounds so gross when you think about it. But I went bowling and I had on flats and I completely forgot, you know, I need socks. So I had to actually buy a pair. They had a vending machine that had socks in it. So very cute. So that's what that building was for. I really thought that was a cute idea and it turned out quite lovely. And then across the way from that is the restroom area, and that is in its own complete building. There are no restrooms in the main building of the mall structure. All of the restrooms are on there in a standalone building opposite of where you can rent your roller skates. So it's quite a large space. I don't know why I made it so large. I don't think I realized I was making it as large as it is until I started to place the toilets, and then I realized, ooh, I can fit two toilets in here. So there's quite a bit of stalls in there. I think there's eight total. And then I did use the gender specific doors just because I wanted that look of the restroom door look in the build. I don't normally use those, but I thought it was quite fitting for this type of build. So yeah, I thought I really like how these little houses turned out. I like the idea of having a bunch of little structures on one lot. So it was I like it. I think it turned out pretty cute. On the inside, I used some of those stone sinks that I've never used before, and I wanted to give it a little bit of a rustic-y outdoor feel. And then I just included a couple of the vanities or the cabinets from the Jungle Adventures, which are my favorites. So for the main structure, this is the first time I built something on an angle, and I didn't realize, well, it wasn't something that I actually thought about, but you have to accommodate for that when you're placing stairs. So originally, when I was putting the stairs in to lead up to the second level of the main building of the mall, I realized that I needed to make some adjustments to the wall placements because stairs don't really fit on an angle, so I had to bump out some of the walls in order to create a proper landing for the stairs. But in the end, I love how it turned out. I love how it made the build just look overall. I think it made it more interesting, and I loved it. So for the restaurant, it is, like I said, completely outdoors, but there is an overhang cover over the main portion of the restaurant seating area, and then on either side of that, it is not covered, and that's where the larger tables are. There's not a ton of seating, but there are two tables that will seat, excuse me, four Sims. If you needed a larger or more chairs for a larger party, you could add a couple of more chairs to one of those larger tables to make it seating for six. And then I used some of the base game square tables, and then I switched out a couple of them for a couple of round tables just to kind of mix up the type of table shapes that were in there. And originally, the chairs that I used had like a pink tint to it, but I didn't feel like that really went with the theme of the build. So I did change those out for a more green color, a lighter green color, because this build was quite dark. There's a lot of dark, rich woods, and I just wanted to have some lighter elements mixed in to kind of brighten it up and give it a little bit of pop. So those chairs do have a lighter green color, and then I think I changed the color of the tables also to a bit of a warmer brown. So in the restaurant, the kitchen is sectioned off by some archways, which I thought turned out quite cute. Originally, I had a kitchen door there, but it was off center and it was really bugging me. I really hate when things are, not centered properly. So I got rid of that and I just created the archways instead. So it was a bit more appealing to the eye. And then the kitchen is just a functional kitchen for a restaurant. I use some of those pantry storage bins that came with the base game, and then your kitchen unit that's required, or the cooking station that's required for the restaurant to function, and then a couple of counters and some clutter items to make it look like a working kitchen. Nothing too extravagant in there. I did use that spoon. Oh, I made a new word, foon. A spoon and a fork deco item, which I really love that one. I think it's super cute. Excuse me. So, that is it for that. No, technically, this lot is a restaurant, but it does have the retail shops included as part of the mall. So, if you did not want this to be a restaurant focus in your game, you can change the lot type to a retail space, and then you should be able to use the retail spaces as a functional retail or a functional lot. I don't think there's anything else that you'll need to add in order for it to function properly. There are cash registers inside each of the shops. The only thing that you'll need to do is to toggle on some of the items for sale. I was not able to do that because it is not a retail lot. It is currently a restaurant. But if that was something that you wanted to do, it would be something that you could easily switch over if you wanted that in your game. So for the skating rink area, I wanted it to have like almost like it was built into the ground. Like there was a hole that was dug into the ground, obviously. And then they just put the roller rink within that hole. So I didn't want it to look like it was like concrete or constructed. I wanted it to look more natural. So I did put in a bunch of rocks and bushes and plants down there, and I started to stack them up. But the idea was that I was going to have them lining all of the walls of that sub-level, and then have it look like it was completely part of the earth, and then the roller rink was just placed within. But I decided just to, you know, do some of the rocks but not have it completely line all the way up to the top, just because there was a lot of rocks going in and I didn't want this lot to be laggy. It's a larger lot. This was actually built in Brindleton Bay on the pet hospital lot. So it's a larger lot and I didn't want it to get laggy. Sometimes if you're putting too many items, then, you know, the larger lots can get laggy, and I didn't want anyone to have issues with that. I wanted it to be very functional and playable for everyone. So I limited the amount of rocks that I used, but I still think it gives off that same kind of feeling that I was going for. I just lined the walls with some of the darker woods so it looked more natural, a bit more rustic, and maybe, you know, have a kind of dirt feel to it to accomplish the look that I was going for. In the front, I just added a half fence on either side on a diagonal, and then I placed some bushes and trees and plants out there just to make the entranceway a bit more appealing. And then on the other side of that fence, there are a couple of benches so your Sims can sit down, chill, and relax. Parents can hang out there if they're, you know, at the roller rink with their children and just watching them have a good time. And, you know, there's a place that they can just hang out and be able to see everything that's going on while their kids are skating. So that was the idea for that. So for the retail shops, there are two downstairs and two upstairs. On the lower level, there is a bookstore and a bath and soap store. The bookstore has a bunch of different surfaces that I've placed in there, and then I put a bunch of books and a magazine rag, and I just added those items all around the space to resemble, you know, books that were for sale, or, you know, you might want to pick one up and check it out and start to read a bit before you purchased it. So I did put a love seat in there from the Seasons pack, which I love, love, love the furniture that came with that pack. And then in the other store that's on the lower level is the bath and body store. It has a bunch of the items that come with, I think some of them are base game, maybe some spa day things in there, some towels, some robes, the toiletry items, things like that. I just placed a bunch of those things around the store, again, on some surfaces, different surfaces. So those are the items that you could toggle on for sale if you wanted to use this as a retail lot. And then on the second level, the stores that are up there are a home and furniture store and then a clothing store. So the home and furniture store actually has two separate sections to it. So it's the largest store. The clothing store is the same size as the other two stores. I really love how the clothing store turned out. I just lined a bunch of the clothing racks in there, as well as some of the cabinets that came with the Seasons pack and one base game that has the towels and things like that within it. I just lined those around the store, as well as some more shoe racks and a couple of other knick-knacky things in there, just to make it like a cute little clothing store. I originally put some mannequins in there that I was going to dress up in outfits that could also be for sale, but because when I built this lot, it is a restaurant lot, I wasn't able to do that, or if there is a way to do that, I couldn't figure out how to do it. So I think if you change the lot type to a retail store, you should be able to easily go in and set the mannequins' outfits so you can have those for sale, which would be really cute, but I did remove them. So if you wanted to do that, you'd have to add the mannequins back into the build, which would be easy to do. And then in the home and kitchen store, I was going for like a Bed Bath & Beyond type feel. So the first part of the store when you walk in has all of your kitchen items. So I placed like pots and pans and the plates and different buckets and bins and that type of thing on shelving in there. And I think I used some of the shelves that came with Laundry Day as well. It turned out pretty cute. And then in the room just behind that, there's a bunch of furniture items, some area rugs, and electronics and lamps and that type of thing. So pretty much you can do all of your shopping that you would need at this one location, as well as having some good eats and some entertainment and fun with the roller rink. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this build. I really loved building it. I loved how it turned out. If you guys did enjoy this video, please give me a thumbs up. And if you are not already subscribed, please hit that subscription button and tap that notification bell so you can be notified when I'm releasing brand new content. If you'd like to stay up to date with what I'm doing, you can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Tumblr. All of those will be linked down below. And also, if you would like to get this build in your game, I will have the download link below as well, so you can click that and have it in your game right now. So thank you guys so much. As always, thank you so much for joining me here today, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, guys.
Find the right words to say to get us back on our